Welcome to the Bougie Black Brother Network. Welcome to Car Wax. This is Michael, your Bougie Black Brother, and we are here for our music podcast. And today we're going to go with the R&B feel. And we got two interesting ladies that we really wanted to review on that recently released. And I got my co-host here, Sean.
Ew.
And two unique ladies. One is Sevyn Streeter, and the other is Sza. C, is it C-Z-A?
No, Sza. It's Sza.
Sza.
S-Z-A.
SZA.
Like the RZA, but
the SZA.
Right.
Yeah, so two really diverse ladies, on the spectrum, very different. But so I found them interesting. I'm going to start with Sevyn because that's the first one I actually listened to. And
Sevyn Streeter?
Yeah, so that's the first one I actually listened to. So what is it, 13 tracks, and she's been out for a minute. It looks like she has a couple of things that's out.
How long? Not albums. This is her first album.
Yeah, so it's just kind of a couple of releases that we'll see. But first that I've seen and first that I actually heard. What's your background with Sevyn Streeter?
Sevyn Streeter used to fuck B.O.B. That's my background on her. So after that, I kind of was peeping her out. And, well, I wasn't really peeping her out. I just knew she was fucking B.O.B. And when her album came out, I was like, okay, B.O.B.'s a pretty talented artist. I know he wouldn't just be dating no scrub-ass singer. So let me check out her album. So I checked it out.
So, thoughts?
I like it. You know what I'm saying? Now, she's with Atlantic Records. The reason why I say she's with Atlantic Records is because she can sing. She is an awesome singer. Like, I really enjoyed the album because she showed her diversity. She showed probably like six, maybe eight different styles on the album. She even had a song. I'm going to tell you exactly which one it was. She even had a song on there where she was sounding like SZA.
Really?
Which was like, oh, okay. So for me, I enjoyed it because it was like, she gave me a little bit. She gave me the true essence of like late 80s, 90s R&B. You know what I'm saying? Like she definitely gave me that real touch of how R&B used to sound. Because the way she made this album, R&B don't sound like that no more.
Not quite. Nope.
So
nope.
So I embraced that part of it. Not only that, she can sing. Now, as far as the writing, I can't really give her all the writing credits because it didn't. I don't know. But based off of the singing and her abilities to make tracks, I really like them. Could the beats been better? Yeah. But she's with Atlantic Records. That's the benefit of the doubt that I give her. Because SZA's with TDE, and TDE is Kendrick Lamar. So, mm-hmm. Of course, those beats are going to be hardcore with mad bass and more urban. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
The things that Sevyn Streeter put were urban, but since it was Atlantic Records, they definitely made it a lot broad for everyone to listen to. And she accomplished it.
Shoo. Good album. Not great. Good album. She can sing. I liked how she was singing. It was she was more of a throwback, to your point. You heard her sound before. And she just wanted to do things a little differently. And she tried a couple of little things. There's a lot of singers who try to do things and fail at it. She did it, and it came across pretty well.
The last song,
the production wise, I was pretty much, yeah, it's okay. So I kind of focused on her singing. And you're right. I agree that she has some serious skills. When you have a skilled artist, you want to hear better from them because it's like, damn, she's struggling to come across on this production. So that's where I felt kind of uncomfortable for her. But when I listened to it the second time, I was like, well, she does got some skills. And you said what? I'm sorry. You said to her the last.
She had a. You said it seemed like she was struggling a little bit. Again, that's the record label. That's what the record label presented, pushed out.
No, I get that. I mean, that's no big deal. You know, anyway, I'm kind of looking at, you know, because she did a throwback that I kind of loved, you know, and she kind of changed it because this was the SWV, I think.
Yeah, she did. She only stole hooks. Mm-hmm. Everything she didn't steal no lyrics. I mean, she didn't steal no verses. So this isn't the only throwback hook that she had on here.
No, I'm aware of that. I'm just saying I like how she did it, right? Because, you know, usually when I talk about production wise, I always say, how do you make it different? Even though you're gonna use some of it, but how do you make it different? So I kinda liked it. I liked how she did it. Was it great? No, but I'm like, wow, good way of doing that. So she did really good. So that was one of them that I was like, damn, she took that one, but let me see if it sound the same. And I didn't hear the exact same lyrics, but being sung in a different way. So that's why I'm like, kind of cool.
Yeah, she had a lot of good tracks on here. The track that sounded like SZA was number 12, How Many? Then number 13 was a country track that sounded really good. It was like, wow. She sounds really good. If she was on a better record company, this would be an awesome album. But
no, I agree. I do. Because yeah, so whatever that record company is pushing, that's what went out.
Exactly.
To your point. So there was a couple of just standout cuts, and then there was the rest of the album was being pretty good.
No, what I'm saying is this is the SZA flow. You know what I'm saying? This song doesn't sound like nothing else on the album. You know what I'm saying? So I liked it because it was like, okay, I don't know if you're actually writing this music, but you're singing it really well. You know what I'm saying? And I gotta give you that, because I'm not trying to get into the SZA, but I can put on this Girls Disrupted and on a regular day listen to the whole CD. On a bad day, still listen to half of the tracks, because it still has an R&B structure to it. There's a couple of other songs that's like, oh, okay, that's cool. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, again, for R&B feel, this is beautiful. You know, I was impressed by her singing. I wasn't impressed by the overall album because her singing was so good and the music presented wasn't, it wasn't showing you how well her abilities was.
Oh, yeah. So you could kind of ignore it. So that's why I liked it, but I doubt if I put it back on, because I like a whole feel for me to actually enjoy the album. So if it's a whole feel, then I'll say, oh, I'll throw that one on because it has a good feel. Here, I'm just saying this is a really good singer, but damn, these songs are just ugh. So I wouldn't put it back on.
Wow.
But to give her the respect of, hey, this is, you know, you came out with a nice CD, record, whatever. You came out with something pretty good. Hope people see this as she's better than what they put behind her because she's a good singer. But nah, I wouldn't put this back on. Not at all.
That's crazy, because I really like this CD.
Yeah, but you can like it. We get to the scissor.
We didn't rate.
I'm sorry. So what are we rating her?
What are you rating her?
As a good CD, I say a 7, because I think she did a good effort on here. She's a good singer. But overall, it's kind of like, I just hope people don't say, this is terrible. Look, this just sounds bad, and not really listening to her. So, me a 7.
Yeah, I give her she was able to, she made the album. She made the album.
Absolutely.
I give her a 7.5 for making the album.
Absolutely.
So
absolutely.
I definitely give her the utmost credit for what she's did.
Yeah.
She's an awesome artist that made that potentially could have been a very bad album.
And with the potential again.
that could have been a very bad album, but her
skill.
Her skill gave her the 7.5. You know what I'm saying? If she was just a fair singer, because there's not a lot of R&B people, there's not a lot of R&B stars that's out there that's being pushed that can sing like Sevyn Streeter.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah. So to your point, what's out there is it's just ridiculous. And they're pushing just a sound where she can sing. They're not pushing the singer anymore. They're pushing a sound. And she can sing to me. And that's why I give her all the credit. Not giving her much more than that. To your point, if she mixed it just a little bit less, I would say, no. You get a mid to low 6. Because you did good sometimes, but then you fell off. But she had a good effort all the way through, regardless of what they backed her with. So I give her a lot more credit.
Yeah, now that is potential. That's what you call potential.
No, that's what you call potential, because everybody has potential defined separately. But I think she did a great effort. But when you say enjoyable albums, that's when we get to the scissor. And I totally enjoyed this. This was something I didn't expect, and because I haven't heard this sound enough. I haven't heard this style enough. And it was one person that she reminded me of. And when I looked it up, I said, oh, that's who she sounds like. And it was kind of different because it was way back. And now she has a new album out. But I used to play her album all the time. And it was Rez. And she had this feel, and she just went through so much, and it was, I just loved her. I played it so much that I waited for the next one, and then she didn't come out for like, I think 6 years. And I just played the hell out of it. It was almost a soulful rock, and she was just so cool. And even her voice and everything was really cool. But R-E-S. And she had about 3 big singles off of that. The other one was They Say Vision and The Ice King. But she, soon as I heard like 2 to 3 cuts off, I was like, damn, she reminded me of my girl. So, but Scissor's amazing. I'm just going to say it off the point. She was amazing. And there's just a lot more on this album to enjoy. So, you, Sean?
If it wasn't for the beats, this album wouldn't be as much as you think it is.
No, you can't tell me what I think as what you think it is.
Yeah,
so
it is definitely.
The production is cool. I love her sound. And the way I see it was just a great album. But to your point, if it wasn't for the beats, what?
So, basically, this one, I want to stick with the record label. So Sza is signed to Top Dog Entertainment. Totally different record label, totally different approach that you're coming with your artist, totally different sound. I give the record label all the credit for this album, totally all the credit. I believe that she sounds, her sound is good, she sounds like Rihanna. You know, her sound is good, but, you know, is it really her sound? I don't know. I just say I don't know. But for the most part, I just felt like SZA's album, Control, only had one style. Only had one direction. Only had it was tunnel vision. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? It had a whole specific vibe that you had to dig to.
That's what she was.
But the point of that was to make sure we don't. If she stepped outside of that sound that TDE gave her, or that TDE was presenting for her, she would not sound as good as she did. You know what I'm saying? The reason why I say that she wouldn't sound as good as she did is because her lyrics and the tones were, her lyrics was fair. The tones was based off of the production.
Yep.
What the production did.
Yep.
For her voice.
Yep. Totally agree.
So as far as, so that's me looking at it from an artist's perspective. From an artist's perspective, you're hiding behind your record label and your production.
So the artist has a control of the production. I think you said that the last podcast. No, the artist has a control. The artist has a control.
Right.
So, yeah. So I agree. She has no reason to step away from it. It went with what she wanted. So I got that. As soon as you said that, I thought of, what was his name? Guru and Premier. Soon as Guru left out Premier, he had a different sound, and that shit didn't sound good. It didn't sound good. He thought he was better than what his production was. And when he found out he wasn't, he tried some different things, and it was like, wow, that's really innovative. That shit didn't sell. You needed to stick with Premier. So if you think you better than your production, or if you're holding on to production that's making you look good, if you're smart as an artist, you're going to hold on to it. That's why this album was a great total. I'm not thinking about her leaving there. I'm not thinking about her thinking she has a different style and she wants a different style. She presented that one style that went with the production, and that's why I enjoyed it. If she tried something else, depends on the production again. If she sticks with the type of production, like you said, I think she'll be better off. If she goes with something different with her style, it may not sound the same. And then it comes to a big critique like, the fuck are you doing? You were successful with this sound, but yet you want to try this. And to your point, you know, it's similar to Rihanna, but I like the style compared to the Rez and that type of production there too. So again, I respect that. If the production is going to be there and she chooses the production and say this is where it's going to be, hey, I'm going to respect that. Me, on the other hand, I'm that production guy to say, your voice don't sound like this, and I think these are the beats that I'm going to give you, and if you don't like it, okay, I'm good with that. But so I enjoyed this. It was a, and some of the storyline lyrics that she went to, well, I really love Weekend, Doves in the Wind. I'm not sure if Kendrick Lamar needed to be on there, but I think that's a selling point. I did like Love.
That's her label mate.
Right. So, you know, they threw some people in there that was, I liked it. Her little features with a lot of people who was actually singing with her. She just had a lot of good little things inside of here that I really enjoyed. You know, like I said, The Weeknd, that's just a chick talking about her being the side chick. And it was cool. You know, some of her just revealing herself and Broken Clocks, I really like that too. Normal Girl was a great little story that she put together. I'm not sure if she's writing it. I didn't get a chance to kind of look if she did her own lyrics or did someone else actually write these. Do you know by chance?
No, I don't.
So
actually, yeah. I'm pretty sure she does. That's why it took her so long to drop this album. She just tried to figure out how to find some. She didn't know what tracks to pick. And then when you listen to her tracks, that's her writing all of these tracks, bruh. There's nobody that's gonna write these tracks for her. Mm. When you're listening to the lyrics, nah, this is all SZA.
Okay. Yeah, so again, I like her. I liked her the way she wrote it. And to your point, I'm gonna keep it right there. It's like, if it wasn't for the production, I think you'll start listening to another Rihanna cut to your point. But she wrote it per her. And yeah, I really enjoy it. So you didn't like anything on it?
Nah, I didn't say I didn't like anything. I was just giving you my overlay of the album.
I got you.
So it was a cute album. It was a very cute album. It's probably the best way I can say it. Because it wasn't a bad CD. I never said it was a bad CD.
Mm-hmm.
I just said it was it's a cute album. It's real cute.
But you said you gave the production all the credit.
All the credit. You have to give it all the credit. If
I'm just confused. One minute it's the artist, no, and then the next minute
you have to give the production and the record label all the production, because she had better options. Now, if both of these artists were on the same record label, let's just say that.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just throw that out there. Both of the artists were on the same record label. Who mm-hmm. would make a better album?
Sevyn Streeter.
Why?
Because she's a better singer.
She's a better writer, or she's better?
She's a better singer.
Okay.
Because there's a lot of singers that don't sing about shit, but their voice carries whatever they're saying.
Right.
And
so
to me, that she's a better singer. I like her style based on the production that she have. But if you have a better singer, I'm still going to listen to it and say, damn, she can sing her ass off. And I love the way they produce this one. But that's how I'm looking at it.
So you would pick Sevyn Streeter if she was on TDE. So and that's kind of my point. It's like it's the label. You know, of course, again, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. You pick the producer. You pick the producer. You pick the beat, whatever, whatever. But if Atlantic Records don't have that beat and you have to settle with a Pharrell artist and, well, not even Pharrell, because Pharrell was actually on the SZA album. But if you have to settle with these country beat men and these modern pop beat people, you know, you're definitely going to see the difference. You know what I'm saying? So I just feel like
the artist picks the producers, whatever they see. Then whatever you said, you don't know about what's going on. The artist picks the producer.
Yeah.
So now you're saying, no, it's about the company and what they have available. Yeah, I know. But there's a certain style of producers that an artist really goes with, and then what goes with them. Now, if they don't choose to do that, you start to hear a lot of bullshit, and they just choose a lot of bullshit. And there's I'll just say it, the Ugly God, that shit was fucking awesome. He ain't saying shit. He had some clever stuff in there, and I'm going to listen to some more again. But again, you don't have to say shit and have great production. Or you can say some clever things here and there and have a style of your own with great production. It's going to ride. It's just going to ride. She did a good job. I still think she just did a good job at choosing what suited
her. Worked for her.
Yeah. So why would she choose anything outside of that? It's the artist. She just had a good source and good label to be on to be able to choose great production.
Right.
Yeah. But she chose good. That's why, you can say cute. I say very good. Very well done, Scissor. Very well done.
Scissor.
Very well done, Scissor. Very well done. So, 14 tracks on here. So, it was a little more than what Sevyn Streeter had. So, just one more. But it didn't fall off. That was another thing that I enjoyed about it. It didn't fall off like, okay, let me continue to listen to the end of this. Didn't fall off, so I felt good about that. And this is like the third time I'm listening to it. So it's probably to your point, since the production is so good.
That's just kind of the production.
Continues to listen to it. But I still like her style. And then the third time around, I was actually listening to the way she wrote some of these songs. And I was like, damn, that's pretty cool. Again, not great, but pretty cool. So everything is a complete album. I just enjoyed. And for an R&B album, not a lot of great R&B albums out. So I enjoyed this one. This one made me feel a little, yeah. I give it an 8 because I just haven't heard any more. I'm going to look for them now, though, because to your point, there's people that's out there and they keep sounding the same. And then if they sound the same, do they have the same production? If they don't have the same production, do they have the same sound? If they have a different sound, what is it? So it's just real different. And I just enjoyed this one, as opposed to saying that Sevyn Streeter had a good album. I think she's one up on her.
Yeah, I give it a 7.
So, not bad. Yeah, but I'm an 8. I'm not going to really go too high than an 8. But I just got to get my R&B on to say, where does she stand?
I haven't put much R&B on your table. So, you hearing these two as like one of your first 5 of the year?
No, so I listen to a couple of R&B, but, you know, it's typical who you hear. But again, I like new artists. So when I'm hearing the older artists coming out with a couple of stuff, I just push it to the side. But I'm good with it. And I'm looking at a couple more that I'm in. I'm looking at a couple of other electronic artists that I used to listen to. So I'm trying to get a flavor of just not hearing the same thing over and over and start, to your point, here's some R&B. Let's listen to some other R&B. There's a reggae guy that was out that I was listening to. It was okay. It was a little modern type reggae, but it was okay. You know,
Wizkid.
I think it was Wizkid.
Yeah, it was Wizkid.
Yeah. So it was okay. I was like, okay, not bad. And but there's a couple of people that's out, so they deserve the time. And we don't do a lot of R&B. But, hey, why not? If it's out there and it's showing up differently, I'm all into it.
For the record, the Trey Songz album is pretty good. That was out. There's a few more R&B albums that's like, pretty good. But, yeah, just let me know.
Oh, yeah. So, you know, when I go through a couple, you know, I'll shoot them to you. And then if you see something that's kind of, like, standing out, then I think it's okay. So, but these two ladies, good releases. They had some good releases. One favorable more than the other. You should listen to them. I think if you don't, you're kind of missing out. And hopefully you can hear some things that we said or possibly didn't say. But good releases. Again, Sza is on my rotation until I'm jumping to some more stuff. But I'm good to go.
Cool.
So, BougieBlackBrother.com. Get us on Podbean. Get us on Bougie Black Brother Network on YouTube. So, you can start seeing it on YouTube. Sean is taking care of that. So, we'll see a lot of them on there. So, look through the car wax on there. And find us on iTunes and find us on Google Play. Spreaker. A lot of people reached out to me from Spreaker and a couple of other ones that we're trying to keep current. So as you see the current ones out there, you'll be able to jump on them. So any last words?
Check us out on YouTube. Subscribe.
Subscribe, 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 and we'll be there. And leave your comments. We love to hear the comments. We will reply. So, Car Wax, Bougie Black Brother. Peace.
Peace.